Hi guys, welcome again to Sunil Engineering Academy YouTube channel. As we all know, a special complete arithmetic series has been started in our channel and it has been running very successfully. This is another video as a part of that series and let's start the video. In this video, we are going to solve questions based on income and expenditure from ratio proportion. Income is the summation of both expenditure and savings. Income constitute of both expenditure and savings. For an instance, we have earned 100 rupees. We spent 80 of them and we saved 20 of them. Then the summation of the expenditure and saving, the expenditure is 80 rupees and the saving is 20 rupees. The summation of the expenditure and saving gives us the actual earning of us. So we can conclude very easy condition. This is the very simple thing we need to know to solve these type of questions. Income is equal to expenditure plus saving. Just take some questions trying to solve that. A man spent his 2 months income in 3 months time. If his monthly income is 6,000, then find his annual saving. Just read the question again. A man spends 2 months income in 3 months. A man is spending 2 months of his salary in the span of three months. And his monthly income is given by 6,000. And we need to find the annual saving of that person. Annual saving of that person. Okay, take a span of every 3 months. In the span of 3 months, he is spending the salary of 2 months. That means in every 3 months, he is saving the salary of 1 month. For every 3 months, he saves the salary of 1 month. Then for 12 months, that is 1 year. 1 year is equal to 12 months. If he is saving the salary of 1 month for every 3 months, then in 12 months, he can save the salary of 4 months. He can save the salary of 4 months. The salary of each month is given by 6,000 and his savings for the whole year would be 4 times of that 6,000, that is 24,000. Where is that option B? 24,000 would be our answer. His annual saving would be 24,000 or the salary of 4 months. Okay. Very simple question and we solved it very easily. Just move to the next question. Here is a very good question. The salaries of A, B, C are in the ratio of 1:3:4. If the salaries are increased by 5%, 10% and 15% respectively, then the increased salary will be in the ratio. Okay. The salary of three persons, namely A, B, C are given in the ratio of 1:3:4. And their salaries were increased by 5%, 10% and 15% respectively. We need to find the ratio of the increased salaries. Okay. The salaries are given by 1, 3 and 4. Just take it for granted. Just the salaries of A and B, C are take as 1, 3 and 4 as granted. And the salary of A was increased by 5%. When any number is increased by 5%, then it becomes 105% of that value. Are you clear? When any number is increased by 5%, then that value would be the 105. That means 105% of that value. Then 105%. We don't need to write the 100 below 105. And when a number is increased by 10%, it will become 110% of that value. That means 110% of that value. And when a number is increased by 15%, it becomes the 115% or the 115% of that number. And gets cancelled, 521s, 522s and 523s. This gives us the required answer. 21 into 3, that is 66. 23 into 4, that is 92. The increased salaries ratio would be 21:66:92. Where is that? 21:66:92, that is option B. Option B would be our answer. The salaries of ABC were given as 1:3:4 and just take that values as granted, 1, 3, 4 we don't have a problem here. And the salaries are increased in the ratio of 5%, 10% and 15% respectively. And we need to find the ratio of the increased salaries. When any number is increased by 5%, it becomes the 105% of that number. And when increased by 10%, it becomes 110% of that number, and so on. When simplified the ratio of 105, 3 into 110, 4 into 115, we are going to get the 21:66:92. This would be our answer. Or if you like to solve the question according to the percentage, just take the salaries of A, B, C as 1:3:4. The ratio is given by 1:3:4. And to calculate the percentage, hundreds are very easy for us. When we have a numbers in terms of hundreds, then we can get the percentage values very easily. That is why take the salaries of A, B, C as 100 rupees, 300 rupees and 400 rupees. When increased by 5%, the 100 becomes 105. When increased by 10%, the 10% of 300 is nothing but 30 rupees. When 300 increased by 30 rupees, it becomes 330 rupees. And after increasing 15%, 400 is going to be 460. 15% of 400 is 60 rupees. 15% of 400 is 60 rupees. If we simplified it, 3, or just to take 5, 521s, 566 and 592s. We can solve this question like this also, from the percentage, or just take the values and increase the percentages as given in the question. We can take the answer very easily in both the cases. Option B, 21:66:92 would be our answer. Next one. If monthly income of A and B are in the ratio 2:3 and the ratio of their expenses are in the ratio 5:9, if each of them saves 600 rupees in the year, then their incomes are, the incomes of A and B are given in the ratio 2:3 and their expenses are in the ratio of 5:4 and each of them is saving 600 rupees in the year, and we need to find the income of the given persons. Okay, here 2 and 3, the ratio 2:3 indicates the incomes and the ratio 5:9 indicates the expenses. When we subtract expenditure from income, then we get savings. We have seen in the previous basic videos that when we take the income ratio of A and B, that would be 2:3 according to the given question. And their expenses are in the ratio 5:9. When the expenditure is subtracted from the income, we got the savings. That is 600 each. The same question can be perceived as two numbers are in the ratio 2:3. When 600 is subtracted from the both the cases, the ratio would become 5:9. We have solved these type of questions in the previous videos. So this is not a new case. This case is older case that was in the other terminology in the previous videos. What we had done there, just took the multiplication of this diagonal, that is 2:9, that gives us 18. Take the multiplication or product of these two, that is 5:3, that is 15. Take the difference between them and then take a product of these two and these two and compare that difference with the difference between 18 and 15, and we are going to solve the question very easily. I think you have understood what we are going to do. This mechanism was done by us in the previous videos. This is not new for us. 9 2s are 18 and 5 3s are 15. The difference is 3. 9 2s are 18. The difference between 18 and 15 is 3. Just compare that 3 with the difference between 5:600 and 9:600. That is 4:600. That is 4:600. 3 1s and 3 200s. That means the one unit value is nothing but 800. When one unit value is nothing but 800, we need to find the incomes of the given persons A and B. when one unit is 800, the value of A, that is 2 units, would become 1600, and the value of B, that is 3 units, would become 3 times of the 800, that is 2400, 2400. The incomes of the A and B are 1600 and 2400 respectively. Where is that? 1600 and 2400 respectively. We have solved this question very easily. If the income of X and Y are in the ratio 4:3 and the ratio of their expenditures are in the ratio 12:7, if each of them saves 3200 rupees in the monthly income of X is, the income of X and Y are in the ratio 4:3. The income ratio is given by 4:3. And the ratio of their expenditures is 12:7. 12:7 is the ratio of their expenditure. This is the income ratio and this is expenditure ratio. We not need to write all these I's and E's. Just write the ratios of the 4:3 and 12:7. We don't need these ones. And each one is saving 3200, each one is saving 3200. And we need to find the monthly income of X. Some faculties say just look for the multiple of 4. If we go through the options, all the given 4 options are the multiples of 4. We have to solve the question here. Just apply the same mechanism which we had applied in the last question. 4:7, that is 28. 12:3, that is 36. Just take the difference between 28 and 36, that is 8. Compare that 8 with the multiplication, the product of the 12:3200 and 7:3200, that is 5:3200. 8 ones and 8 fours, 8 hundred, 400s. That means the value of the 1 unit is 2000. The value of 1 unit is 5:400, that is 2000. When the value of 1 unit is 2000, then the value of X, that means the X, this is Y, the value of X, that is 4 units. When 1 unit is 2000, 4 units becomes 8000. That 8000 is the income of X. Where is that? That 8000, option B, 8000 would be the income of X. And next one. The incomes of Ram and Shyam are in the ratio 5:3. The expenses of Ram, Shyam and Geeta are in the ratio 8:5:2. If Geeta spends 2000 and Shyam saves 700, then Ram saves. Very interesting question. Just read the question again. In the first line, we are given by the incomes of Ram and Shyam, which is in the ratio of 5:3. In the second statement, the expenses of Ram, Shyam and Geeta, a new character Geeta was introduced here. Ram, Shyam and Geeta, the expenses of Ram, Shyam and Geeta are in the ratio of 8:5:2. And Geeta spends 2000 rupees. The expenditure of Geeta was given in the rupees, 2000 rupees. And Shyam saves 700 rupees. Then we need to find the what Ram is going to save. Okay. The incomes, just take the incomes of Ram, Shyam as 5:3. And the expenditures are given by, and the expenditures of Ram, Shyam and Geeta are given in the ratio of 8:5:2. We don't need to write all these R, S and G's, so that means the indicating names of the given persons. When you are very familiar with the questions of the arithmetic, then you don't need to write all those things. Just for the sake of the newcomers who are just started learning the arithmetic, I will write these things. Okay, these are not necessary things, just for the sake of understanding for the newcomers who are amateurs to the arithmetic. Okay, the incomes of Ram and Shyam are in the ratio 5:3 and the expenditures of Ram, Shyam and Geeta are in the ratio 8:5:2. And here we got a solution, here we got a hint that Geeta spends 2000. When the expenditures of Ram, Shyam and Geeta are in the ratio 8:5:2 and Geeta spends 2000, that means 2 is indicating 2000, 2 indicates 2000, then 5 indicates 5000 and 8 indicates 8000. The expenditures of the 3 persons are 8000, 5000 and 2000 respectively. And Shyam saves 700. after spending 5000, after spending 5000, Shyam is able to save 700. Then his income would be, then his income, that is represented by 3 in the ratio, that 3 units would be 5700 rupees. After spending 5000, Shyam is able to save 700 rupees. Then his total income should be 5700 rupees. That is represented by 3 in the ratio of their incomes. When 3 becomes 5700, the income of Ram, that is the income of Ram 5 becomes 3 into 19, that in the same way 5 into 19, that is 9500. The income of Ram is 9500. After spending 8000, Ram's expenditure was 8000. After spending 8000 out of 9500, Ram is going to be save 1500. Ram's saving would be 1500. Where is that option D? 1500 is our answer. Okay, very interesting question. And this was asked in the previous examinations which were conducted recently. Very good question also. The income ratio of the Ram and Shyam was given, and the expenditure ratio of Ram, Shyam and Gauri was given. And the Geeta spends 2000. When the expenditure ratio of the Ram, Shyam and Geeta was in the ratio of 8:5:2, and the Geeta's value in terms of rupees is 2000, then the respective ratios of respective values of Ram and Shyam would be 8000 and 5000. After spending 8000, Ram's, after spending 5700, Shyam is able to save 700 rupees. Then the income of Shyam would be 5700. Then the income of Ram would be 9500. Okay. After spending 8000 out of 9500, Ram is going to be save 1500. Next one. If annual income of A and B are in the ratio 5:3, the annual income of A and B are given. Just look at this. Annual income of A and B are given in the ratio 5:3, and the ratio of their expenditures are in the ratio 9:5, and their expenditure ratio is 9:5. If they save 2600 and 1800 respectively, and they are able to save 2600 and 1800 rupees respectively, then their incomes are, we need to find the incomes of the given persons A and B. Okay, we don't have a problem here. We are going to solve this question again in the same way which was employed in the previous questions. The income of A and B are in the ratio 5:3. This is the income ratio. I am not going to write I, E, S, S, that are the indicating letters of the income, saving and expenditure respectively. 5:3, this is the ratio of the income, and the ratio of their expenditure is 9:5, or the ratio of their expenditure is 9:5. They are able to save 2600 and 1800 after spending in the ratio of 9:5. The savings are in the ratio 2600 and 1800. Just I am not writing the hundreds. Just observe here, 26 indicates the 2600 and 18 indicates the 1800. For the sake of time saving and for the sake of time saving only. Just 26 is represents 2600, 18 represents 1800. We don't have a problem. If you have a problem, just write the two zeros also. Or just write 26 and 18, and remember those are hundreds, 2600 and 1800s. Just I wrote 26 and 18 for the convenience only. Take the difference between 5 5s and 3 9 3s, that is 25 and 27. The difference between 27 and 25 is 2, and the difference between 18 into 9, 162 and 130. The difference between those two is 32. The 2 indicates 32, but 32 here indicates the hundreds, 32 hundreds, because 26 and 18 are in terms of hundreds. So the 2 is nothing but 3200s, 2 ones and 2 16. The value of 1 unit would be 1600. The value of 1 unit would be 1600. Then the values of the 5 and 3 are going to be respectively 5 into 16, that is 8000. 16 into 3, that is 4800. The incomes of A and B respectively 8000 and 4800. 8000 and 4800. That is option A. 8000 and 4800. Okay. Next one. ఏ అండ్ బి ఇస్ మంత్లీ ఇన్కమ్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ది రేషియో 8:5. ది మంత్లీ ఇన్కమ్ ఆఫ్ ఏ అండ్ బి ఇస్ 8:5 అండ్ దర్ మంత్లీ ఎక్స్పెండిచర్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్ 5:3. ఇఫ్ ది సేవ్ 12,000 అండ్ 10,000 రెస్పెక్టివ్లీ దెన్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ ఇన్ దేర్ ఇన్కమ్స్ ది ఇన్కమ్స్ ద మంత్లీ ఇన్కమ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఏ అండ్ బి ఈజ్ 8:5 అండ్ ది ఎక్స్పెండిచర్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ ది రేషియో 5:3 అండ్ ది సేవింగ్స్ ఆర్ 12,000 అండ్ 10,000. హియర్ 12 అండ్ 10 ఇండికేట్స్ థౌజండ్స్. ఫర్ ది కన్వీనియన్స్ ఐ రోట్ ఓన్లీ 12 and 10, బట్ రిమెంబర్ ది నెంబర్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్ థౌజండ్స్. The difference between 8 threes are 24 and 5 fives are 25. The difference between them is 1, and the difference between 50 and the difference between 36 is 14. That 14 represents 14,000. Not only is 14, that represents 14,000. And the difference of their incomes, the incomes ratio is 8:5, and the difference of their incomes would be the difference between the ratio, that is the difference between 8 and 5 is 3. The difference between 8 and 5 is 3. If the one unit value is 14,000, one unit value is 14,000, then the 3 units value would be 3 times of the 14, that is 42,000, 42,000s. Where is that option A? 42,000 would be our answer. Okay. This is the very best method to solve these type of questions. You can solve these questions within 4 or 5 seconds by employing this method. This is the best solution for solving these type of questions. Next one. The incomes of A and B are in the ratio 7:5. Their expenses are in the ratio 9:8. An increase of A's expenditure by rupees 100 and a decrease of B's expenditure by rupees 200, their savings would be 400 each. Find the average of their incomes. Very good question. Just read the question. Pause the video and read the question again. Now, I hope you pause the video and read the question. Okay. The incomes of A and B were in the ratio 7:5. The incomes are in the ratio 7:5. And their expenses were in the ratio 9:8. The expenses are in the ratio 9:8. Okay. Then what are the savings? If A's expenditure, an increase of A's expenditure by 100 rupees and a decrease of B's expenditure by 200, then their savings would be 400 each. After spending something, A is able to save something. If A's expenditure are increased by 100 rupees, then he would be able to save 400 rupees. If the expenditure was not increased by 100 rupees, let us assume if the expenditure was not increased by 100 rupees, then a person who is able to save 400 rupees would be able to save 500 rupees. After spending 100 more rupees, A is able to save 400 rupees. If he has not spent that 100 rupees, then he would be able to save 500 rupees. The saving of A would be 500 rupees. The actual saving of A was 500 rupees. Okay. Just look at the B's case. And a decrease of B's expenditure by 200 rupees, then B would be able to save 400 rupees. After decreasing the expenditure of B by 200 rupees, B would be able to save 400 rupees. If he had spent that 200 also, then he would be able to save 200 only. Then he would be able to save 200 only. Just take the same mechanism here again. 7 8s are 56, 9 5s are 45. The difference between 56 and 45 is 11. Just to compare that 11 with 9 2s are 18, 5 8s are 40, that is 22 hundreds. 11 1s and 11 2s, that is 200. The value of the one unit is 200. And we need to find the average of their incomes. When the value of the one unit is 200, the sum of their incomes would be 12 units. The summation of 7 and 5. That is 12 units. The average, we need to find the average of their incomes. When summation is 2400, that is 12 into 200, the sum of their incomes would be 12 units. 1 unit is 200, then 12 units would be 12 into 200. But we need to find the average. So average is nothing but sum by number. Sum is 12 into 200, and the number here is the two quantities, A and B are two quantities, so the number would be 2 ones and 200s, then the average would be 1200. average of their incomes would be 1200. Where is that option C? 1200 would be our answer. Just observe the middle portion of the question. After an increasing of 100 rupees, after an increasing of expenditure of A by 100 rupees, he would be able to save 400 rupees. If he had not spent that 100 rupees, then he would be able to save 500 rupees. And decreasing of B's expenditure by 200 rupees, he would be able to save 400 rupees. If he spent that 200 also, if he spent that 200 also, assume that his expenditure was not decreased. He spent in a general way, then he would be able to save only 200 only. Okay. If you are able to take that values, then the question would be solved very easily. The required average of their incomes would be 1200. That is option C. Next one. The incomes of A and B are in the ratio 5:6 and their expenses are in the ratio 7:9. A decrease of A's expenditure by 500 and the increase of B's expenditure by 500 makes their savings rupees 17,500 each. Find the sum of their incomes. The same question which we have solved just now. This type of question. The same question here again. The incomes of A and B are in the ratio 5:6 and the expenditure ratio was 7:9. The ratio of the expenditure is 7:9. Just observe here carefully. The expenditure, a decrease of A's expenditure by 500 urged him to save 17,500 rupees. If A's expenditure was decreased by 500, that means his saving was increased by 500. If expenditure is decreased by 500, then saving would increase by 500. After increased by 500, the saving was 17,500. So the actual saving would be 17,000 only. 17,000 only. Here 17 represents 17,000. For the convenience, for the sake of our convenience, I wrote 17 only. If B's expenditure was increased by 500, then his saving would decrease by 500. If expenditure is increasing, saving would decrease. After increasing the expenditure by 500, he would be able to save 500 less than the previous ones. Then his actual saving would be 18,000. After increasing the expenditure by 500, he would be able to save 17,500 only. If he had not spent that 500, then he would have been able to save 18,000. This 18 represents 18,000. Remember, here 17 and 18 represents thousands. Just to employ the same mechanism. This is the best method to solve these type of questions. Wherever you go, whether internet, whether to another videos, this is the best method I can say. The product of 519 is 45 and 76 is 42. The difference between 45 and 42 is 3. And take the difference between 18 sevens. 126 and 17 into 9, that is 153. That is 27. The difference between 153 and 126 is 27. Here 126 is nothing but the product of the 7 and 18, and the product of 17 and 9 is nothing but 153. And we need to take the difference between them. We need to take the difference between, that is nothing but 27. That then the value of one unit is 9. That means 9,000. It represents 9, not only 9. It represents 9,000s. What we need to find? We need to find the sum of their incomes. Sum of their incomes would be 11 parts. When one unit represents 9,000, then 11 units represents 99,000. So 99,000. Where is that 99,000? Option B, 99,000 would be sum of their incomes. That is what we need to find. Move to the next question. The ratio of expenditures and savings is 3:2. If the income increased by 15% and the savings increased by 6%, then by how much percent should his expenditure increase? Yes. Okay. Just read the question again. The ratio of expenditure and savings are in the ratio 3:2. And income increases by 15% and the savings increased by 6%. Then by how much percent should his expenditure increase? Okay. Let's solve this question in two different ways. First one is from the method of deviation from the average concept. average concept method of deviation. The expenditure and saving ratio was given in the ratio of 3:2. The expenditure and saving ratio was given by 3:2. Then what is the income? If it take the summation of the expenditure and saving, that would be income. Then the income would be 5 units. When expenditure is 3 units, saving is 2 units, the income would be summation of expenditure and saving. That means 5 units. Summation of 3 + 2, that is 5 units. Okay. The income was increased by 15%. Income was increased by 15%, and the expenditure, the saving was increased by 6%. The saving was increased by 6%. Saving was increased by 6%. From the average, from the method of deviation concept, it is supposed to be increased by 15% on each of the income, expenditure, and saving. Then the whole increase would be 1500. But the increase in the saving was supposed to 15%, but it was 6% only. That means it was less than what we anticipated by 9%. The actual increase in the saving 6% was 9% less than what we anticipated, that is 15. That 9%, but for two units, for 1 unit is 9%, for 2 units it would be 9 × 2. But that deficit has to be bared by the 3 units here. But the deficit has to be bared by 3 units here. That means 3 ones and 3 threes. It has to be 6% more than what we anticipated. To maintain the 15% on the income, the expenditure would be 6% more than what we anticipated. That is nothing but 15 + 6, that is nothing but 21%. That is option C. Or if we solve this by allegation method, from the method of allegation, income is the combination of expenditure and saving. Expenditure and saving collectively gives us income. So the middle portion, the mean portion, should be income, and the two components of income should be written like this: the expenditure and saving imply the same mechanism. Expenditure, we need to find the value of expenditure, we don't have that. And income was increased by 15%. Income was increased by 15% and the saving was increased by 6%. But the ratio of the expenditure and saving was given by 3:2. The ratio of the expenditure and saving was given by 3:2. The difference between 15 and 6 is 9%. When 3 represents 9%, then 2 represents 3. 3s are 9, 2 3s are 6. Then 2 represents 6%. When we subtracted 6 from 15, it gives 9. And again, we need to subtract that 15 from this number to get 6. From 21, when we subtract 15, we are going to get 6. Or the summation of 15 and 6 gives us 21. So the increase in the expenditure should have been 21%. From the allegation rule also, we can solve the question very easily. Or from the method of deviation, which is learned from the average also, we can solve the question very easily. Okay. Next one. Rama's expenditure and savings are in the ratio 5:3. His income increases by 12% and expenditure by 15%. Then how much percent do the savings increases? The same question again. Try to solve the question on the both the methods we have learnt just now. First of all, method of deviation, from the method of deviation, or from the method of average, or from the method of average. The expenditure and saving were in the ratio 5:3. Expenditure and saving were in the ratio 5:3. Then income would be 8 units. Income is increased by 12%. Here income was increased by 12%. Just observe here, income was increased by 12% and the expenditure by 15% and the expenditure by 15%. Then how much percent to savings increases? We need to find the increase in the savings. The income was increased by 12%. The expenditure and savings are the components of income. If there were 12% uniform increase on all the components of the income, then the increase in the income would have been 12%. But here the increase in the expenditure was 15% rather than 12%. It was more than 3% than we anticipated. It was 3% more than what we anticipated. It is supposed to be 12% here. If there is an increase of 12% on the savings and 12% on the expenditure, then the increase on the income would be 12% only. But according to the question, it was not 12%. The increase in the expenditure is 15%. It is supposed to be 12%, but 15% is 3% more than what is anticipated. 3%. But for 5 times, that means 3 into 5, that was the increase. Here we have the excess value. We are supposed to get 12%, but we got 15%, that means we got excess value. The 3 times of the 5 is the excess value, and this excess can be decreased by these, can be neglected by these 3%. That means for each person it can be neglected by 5. It can be decreased by 5 to maintain the same 12%. That means the 5 less than 12, that is 7%. 5 less than 12. Here we have the surplus. In the last question or in the previous question, we was in deficit. It was supposed to be 15%, but it was 6% only. That was deficit. That is why we added 6% more than, we need to be 6% more than the anticipated 15% in the expenditure. But in this question, we had the surplus value. So we can decrease that value by 5. After decreasing 12 by 5, we got 7%. That is our answer. Or from the allegation also, we can solve the question very easily. The increase in the income is 12% and the expenditure is 15%. We need to find the value of the savings. And the savings and the expenditure and savings were in the ratio 5:3. The expenditure and saving was in the ratio 5:3. The difference between 15 and 12 is 3. When 3 is indicating 3, 5 indicates 5 only. After subtracting 12 from the 15, we got 3. After subtracting 5 from the 12, we got 7. That 7% is the increase in the saving. This is expenditure, this is saving. We don't need to write this S and X. Okay, once we are familiar with the question. 7% increase. Where is that option C? We can solve this question very easily in both the methods. Next one. If the ratio of the income of A, B and C are in the ratio 5:6:7 and their savings are 1:2:3. If the ratio of A's income and B's savings is 5:4, find the ratio of C's income to A's saving. Okay. Income, so the income ratio of A, B, C. The income ratio of A, B, C was given in the ratio of 5:6:7. And the savings was given in the ratio of 1:2:7. 1:2:3, sorry. 1:2:3. 1:2:3. And again, if the ratio of A's income and B's savings is 5:4. A's income, the ratio between A's income and B's savings was given by 5:4 here. The actual ratio was 5:2 only. This 5 represents the income of A and this 2 represents the savings of B. That ratio was, according to the question, the ratio was given by 5:4. 5:4. Sorry, 5:4. Okay. Sorry, this is a printing mistake in that question. This 5 should have been 15. This 5 should have been 15. There is a printing mistake in the question. I'm sorry for that. And I promise you, there would be no printing mistake again in my videos. Okay. The incomes of, if the ratio of A's income and B's income is 15:4, find the ratio of C's income to A's savings. C's incomes to A's savings. Okay. We need to make that 5:15 and we need to make this 2:4 to get this ratio. To do that or to get that, just multiply the income by 3 times and multiply the saving ratio by 2. If you multiply the income ratio of ABC, we are going to get 3 times of 5, that is 15, 3 times of 6, that is 18. We don't need all these things. Just we only need the income of A and ratio of C's income, the income of C also, 21, that is 21, and 2 4 and 6. 2, 4 and 6 are the values after multiplying 2. Then the ratio of the C's income to saving. C's income is 21 rupees and A saving, the saving of A was 2 rupees. 2 rupees. 21 is to 2 would be our answer. There is that option A. 21 is to 2 would be our answer. Okay. This is 15, not 5. Sorry for my printing mistake or my typing mistake. This would not repeat again. Next one. Three persons A, B, C whose salaries together amounts to 77,000 spends 80%, 85% and 75% of their salaries respectively. If their savings are in the ratio of 8 is to 9 is to 10, then A's salary is an. Very good question. Just look at the question. A, B, C are three persons and sum of their salaries is 77,000. A, B, C spent their salaries 80% and 85% and 75% respectively. And their savings were in the ratio of 8 is to 9 is to 10. We need to find the salary of A. Okay. After spending 80%, A would be able to save 20% of his salary only. Are you getting the point here? After spending 80% of salary, A would be able to save 20% of A. 20% of his salary. After spending 85%, A would be able to save 20% of his salary. 20% of A. After spending 85%, B would be able to save only the 15% of his salary. That means 15% of B. After spending 75% of his salary, C would be able to save 25% of his salary. But the ratio was given in the ratio was 8 is to 9 is to 10. The ratio was 8 is to 9 is to 10. 20% of A is to 15% of B is to 25% of C is 8 is to 9 is to 10. Then what is the ratio of A is to B is to C? Then what is the ratio of A is to B is to C? 5 fours, 5 threes, and 5 fives. 4A is to 3B is to 5C is equal to 8 is to 9 is to 10. Then A is to B is to C was. I have discussed about this in my previous videos. I never left just an inch of subject also. I have covered all these things. To get the value of A, just take the value from the ratio and multiply it with the other two variables of B and C. To write the value of A, take the value of A from the ratio 8 and multiply it with the other than two components, that is B and C, the coefficients of B and C, that is 3 into 5, that is 15. Take the product of B and C. Take 9 from the ratio and multiply it with the other two, other than B, A and C, the coefficients of A and C. Take the coefficients of A, product of the coefficients of A and C, that is 4 into 5, that is 20. To write C, take 10 from the ratio and write the product of the coefficients of O other than C, that is A and B, that is 4 into 3, that is 12. Once we reduce this ratio into lowest terms, that means we can take 60, 62s, 63s and 62s. The ratio of the salaries of A, B, C, A is to B is to C was 2 is to 3 is to 2. C was 2 is to 3 is to 2. And we are given with the summation of the their salaries. Then 2 plus 3 plus 2, that is 7. 7 is equal to 77,000. Then the salary of A, that is 2 units. When 7 units was 77,000, 2 units was 22,000. 22,000. Where is that? Option C, 22,000 was the salary of A. Or if you solve these from the percentage, just look at the ratio of ABC, the salaries of ABC. After spending 80%, A would be able to save only 20%. That 20% was given as 8 in the ratio. That 20% was given as 8 in the ratio. 8. If 20% of A is 8, then 100% of A would be 40. Then the 100% of A would be 40. After spending 85%, B would be able to save 15% of his income. The 15% of B was 9 according to the ratio. According to the ratio, the 15% of B was 9. When 15 is 9, then what is the value of 100? 5, 3 5s and 3 3s, 60. That value is 60. After spending 75%, C would be able to save 25% of his income, that is given by 10. 25% of C was 10, then 100% of C would be 40. 25 fours in the same way, 10 into 4, that is 40. When we simplify this ratio, 22s, 23s and 22s, the salaries of ABC was in the ratio 2:3:2. And some of their ratio, some of their salaries was 7 units, that 7 by unit C is equal to 77,000. Then the salary of A, 2 units would be 22,000. 22,000. Where is that? Option C. 22,000 would be our answer. We can solve this question in both the ways. The income of A, B, C are in the ratio of 7:9:12. And their spendings are in the ratio of 8:9:15. If A saves 1/4 of his income, then the savings of A, B, C are in the ratio of. Very good question. I can say this is very best question, and we can expect these type of questions in the coming examinations. The incomes of ABC, the incomes of ABC, income of A, B and C was in the ratio of 7:9:12, 7:9:12, and their spendings are in the ratio of, their spendings were in the ratio of 8:9:15. Their spendings were in the ratio of 8:9:15. And read the last statement here. If A saves 1/4 of his income, then the savings of ABC are in the ratio of. A was able to save 1/4 of his income. From the given ratios, we are not comfortable to get the 1/4 of what is A. If you like to solve this from the basic or traditional methods, we would say, we would take the incomes of ABC as 7x, 9x and 12x, and we would take the savings of, we would take these spendings of, and means expenditure. This is expenditure, let indicate with expenditure. The expenditures, let take the ratio of expenditures as 8y, 9y and 15y. Then 7x minus 8y would be 1/4 of 7x. That is the traditional method. But we are not going to solve by traditional method, we are going to employ some advanced methods. Okay, first of all, make the income and expenditure of A same. First of all, just make the income and expenditure of A same. To do that, multiply the equation with 8 and multiply this 8 with this 7. Now income and expenditures are same, but whatever the operation was done on the one term of the ratio should be done on the whole ratio. That is why multiple the all the other terms of the ratio with 8, and here multiple the all the other terms of the ratio with 7. Now the income and expenditures are same, but according to the question, he saves 1/4 of his income. That means he spends three fourths of his income. To make that, multiple that ratio with 4 and multiple this ratio with 3. Now in the last step, the income and expenditure was same. To get the saving, to get the saving as 1/4 of what he earned, just multiply that ratio with 4 and multiply this ratio with 3. Thus same operation should be done on the all the terms of the ratio. All the terms of the ratio. Now we can say that saving of A is 1/4 of what he earned. 1/4 of what he earned. That means 7 into 8, that is 56. How we got 56? That is nothing but the difference of expenditure and, sorry, income and expenditure. That is 56. Here we can take 9 out. 8 4 are 32 and 7 3 are 21. That is 11 into 9. That is 99. Here the difference between the product of 12, 8 and 4 and the 15, 17, 7 and 3. We can take 3. We can take 3 here. 4, 16 and 80, 128, and here 105. The difference between those. 3 into 13, that is 69. The savings of A, B, C was in the ratio 56:99:69. Where is that? 56, 99 and 69. Option A. 56, 99 and 69. That was the ratio what we required. The savings of ABC are in the ratio of 56:99:69. I hope you understand this question. This is the best question. You can expect these type of questions in the coming examinations. And take the next one. The monthly income of A and B are in the ratio 5:4. Their monthly expenses are in the ratio 19:21 and their savings are in the ratio of 37:18. If the total annual savings of A and B is 66,000, A's monthly income is. This is also one of the best questions. The monthly incomes of A and B are in the ratio 5:4. The monthly incomes here, the monthly incomes of A and B are in the ratio 5:4. Their monthly expenses are in the ratio 19:21. Their expenses are in the ratio 19:21. This indicates the income, this is expenditure. Then after subtracting expenditure from the income, we are going to get the saving. But the savings, their savings are in the ratio 37:18. That the savings are in the ratio 37:18. But to solve these equations, we need to get the integers here, not the ratio value, but we need to get the integers here. The total annual saving of A and B is 66,000. The annual saving is 66,000 and the ratio, all these ratios are given for the monthly incomes. Then if the annual saving is 66,000, his monthly saving would be 12th part of this 66,000. Okay, just compare this the savings, the summation of 37 and 18. What is 55? That 55 represents 66,000. The saving ratio was given in the 37:18, but the actual saving was 66,000. That just compare the ratio value 55 with 66,000, and this is annual saving. To get the monthly saving, just divide that by 12. 11 5s and 11 6, 5 1s and 5, 12. That is 100. So the savings, the actual savings of A and B in terms of rupees was 3700 and 1800. Now apply the same mechanism again. 21 into 5, that is 105. 19 into 4, that is 76. The difference between 105 and 76, 29 units is equal to the difference between the product of 19 and 1800 and 37 into 21, that is 19 into 18, 324 and 18, 324, 332, 342, this is 342 and 21 into 37, 37 into 21, 777, just subtract that 342, that is 5, 335. Sorry, this is 4. 3 only, that is 4. 435. 29 15 is 435. And we need to find the monthly income of A. The monthly income of N, the value of 1 unit is 15. The value of 5 units is 75. 75 in terms of 100. 75 hundreds. Where is that? 75 hundred. Option B would be our answer. Option B would be your answer. I hope you understand this question. And let me explain once again. The income ratio was in the 5:4 and the expenditure ratio was 19:21. And their savings were in the ratio of 37:18. And the total annual saving of A and B was given by 66,000. And we need to find A's monthly income, the monthly income of A. The ratio of incomes and expenditure was given in terms of months, and the savings was in terms of year. The annual saving was given. Just take the summation of 37 and 18. From the ratio, the summation of ratio is 55, but the actual value of that 55 is nothing but 66,000. But 66,000 is the annual saving. To get the monthly saving, divide that 66,000 by 12. That is going to be, the value of one unit is going to be 100. If the value of one unit is 100, then the value of 37 units would be 3700 and the value of 18 units would be 1800. Apply the same mechanism, just to take the product of these diagonal and take the difference that is 29, and take the product of 19 and 1800 and 21 and 3700, take that difference. The difference is nothing but 435. 29, 15 is 435. That means the value of 1 unit is 15. Then the income of here, that is 5 units. 5 units would be 75. But the here, the 15 represents hundreds. That is why the income of, monthly income of here would be 7500. That is option B would be our answer. That's all in this video. I hope you learned something very unique in this video, and let's meet in the another video. Please subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications. Whenever we upload a video, you will get the instant notifications, and please share with friends. That would encourage me to do more videos and to give you more supplement. Okay, thank you, and let's meet in the another video. Thank you.